गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. दिस इज डॉक्टर वाई सुजाता रेड्डी, प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. नाउ वी कैन डिस्कस अबाउट लाइन इंक्लाइन टू बोथ एचपी एंड वीपी. इन दिस मेथड्स लाइन इंक्लाइन टू बोथ रेफरेंस प्लेन्स मीन्स हॉरिजॉन्टल रेफरेंस प्लेन एंड वर्टिकल प्लेन. इन दिस केस वी डिस्कस डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स. इन दिस सिचुएशन हियर we find out the true length of the line and true inclinations in rotation line method. Second one is midpoint method. Okay, line incline to both planes have different types of methods. Now we discuss first method. When the line incline to both planes by rotating line method, this is the problem. A straight line AB has its end A 15 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP, and the B end is 50 mm above HP and 75 mm in front of VP. If the distance between the end projectors of the line is 50 mm, draw the projections of the line, determine its true length and true inclination. Here you note down the first given data in this problem. Note down the problem. What is the given data here? The straight line, one end AB above HP 15 mm, in front of VP 20 mm. The end B is 50 mm above HP and 75 mm in front of VP. Okay. This is a given data. End A is 15 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of VP. This is the starting point of the A, and the end B, ending point is 50 mm above HP, 75 mm in front of VP. Distance between the end projectors of the line is 50 mm. Okay, here 5 points are there. First point. And the starting point of the A is above 15 mm, in front of 20 mm. Ending point of the B is 50 mm above HP, 75 mm in front of VP. And distance between the projectors of the line is 50 mm. We maintain the distance of the projectors of the line 50 mm. Okay. In this problem, what we need to find out means here, draw the projections of the line, determine its true length and find its true inclinations. Okay. Now we observe the here step by step. We draw the first one reference line XY, and then in the problem they are given first point A is starting point above 15 mm, above HP 20 mm in front of VP. Okay, that's why here we need to draw the A dash and DA, 15 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of VP. Then after third point, 50 mm is the projectors distance between the two projectors distance between 50 mm. That is the 50 mm two projector distance between. And then after here 15 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of VP. Okay, then after third point 50 mm two projectors distance, and end point B is above HP, the end point above HP in front of VP. Above HP distance here 50 mm, and in front of VP distance is 75 mm. These are the data they are given in the problem. Then here A dash to A is the starting point and B is the ending point. A dash B dash is the front view, A B is the top view. Here and then After we draw the one lines, this is the locus of the lines here. This is the locus of the lines. These are the locus of the lines. A to this line, joint point. A point to join here this line. This line is called locus of line. A top view line. A line. Locus of the line. A line here. And top view to we rotate the A is the center. A is the center. And A to B is the radius. We draw the arc here. A is the center. A to B is the radius. We draw the arc here in this way. A is the center. A to B is the radius. We draw the arc here. Okay, in this way. Then after we join that, this is also one locus of the line. Four lines are there here, locus of the lines. Locus of the line, B dash locus of the line, this is. And then we join the line here, B1 dash to A, A dash, B1 dash to A dash. This is the true length of the line. This is true length of the line and true inclination, theta is equal to 24 here. Okay. Then after theta and alpha. Okay, true inclination and A dash is the center, A dash is the center, A dash to B dash is the radius, you draw the one arc. Then after we extend the line up to here, this locus of the line, B locus of the line, this locus of the line is called A locus of the line, this is the B locus of the line. So here to here extend this line and this length is called as true length of the line. Top view to front view, we extend the lines and front view to top view here. In this way we identify the true length of the line and true inclinations. This method is called rotating line method. In this method, in the problem they are given that projector's distance and A starting point, B ending point. A starting point, B ending point. That means A starting point above HP 15 mm, in front of VP 20 mm. So that's why we put the here A dash is the 15, A is the 20. And then after B ending point, B point ending point, the line ending point is the B. B is the above 50 mm HP in front of VP 75 mm. That's why B dash is the above HP 50 mm, we draw the one locus of the line, above in front of 75 we draw the one locus of the line. Then after we join the lines here A dash to B dash and A to B. Okay, projected distance 50 mm. Then after A is the center, A to B is the radius. A is the center, A to B is the radius. You draw the arc, this locus of the line. Here to here, and then we extend the lines, locus of the line A B1 dash, B dash, B dash locus of the line, and then you join the this point, you join the this B1 dash point to A dash. This is the true length of the line. And next A dash is the center, A dash to B dash is the radius. You draw the arc, this locus of the line, and we extend the line. Here, this locus of the line, B locus of the line, and here to here, B to A, you join the line. This is the true length of the line, and theta alpha, you find out theta is the 24, here phi is the 41. True length and true inclinations. We find the rotating line method. Now we discuss midpoint method. This method is one of the line inclined to both planes HP and VP. The midpoint of a straight line AB 90 mm long is 60 mm above HP and 50 mm in front of VP. It is inclined at 30 degrees to HP and 45 degrees to VP. Draw its projections. So here in this problem, the midpoint of a straight line. Okay, what is the given data here? Midpoint, straight line, midpoint problem. Problem type midpoint, and length of the line is 90 mm, 60 mm above HP, 50 mm in front of VP. It is inclined 30 degrees to HP and 45 degrees to VP. Okay. Next, we draw the here first one line, that is XY and reference line, and at any point above the reference line, at any point, we draw the one horizontal line and we identified the name is M, and above HP they are given in the problem 60 mm above HP, 60 mm above HP. So here 60 mm above HP we draw the one horizontal line. That point is M, and locus of the line also it is called as, that point is 1. 60 mm above HP, 60 mm above HP, and 50 mm in front of VP. So 60 mm above HP, 50 mm in front of VP, we draw the one line M dash and M, and we draw the one horizontal line M locus of the line also. M locus of the line, and this line is called locus of M, this line is called locus of M dash. Okay, this distance above reference line above HP 60 mm, in front of VP 50 mm here, and then after HP inclined 30 degrees to HP and 45 degrees to VP. Okay, HP inclination here with the help of the protractor 30 degrees. We take the here 30 degrees, and after line distance is AB, line distance is, and the distance of the line 90 mm. So here 90 mm. So the problem is midpoint problem. That's why 90 mm length, 45 here and 45 above. This midpoint M dash is there, and we take the here 30 inclined to HP, 30 degrees. After that 45 below the M dash line and off above the 45. Total length of the line is 90 mm. Okay. In this way, we draw the 45, 45. This is the length of the line is 90 mm. Same here also, but inclination is inclined to VP 45 degrees. Inclined to VP 45 degrees. Here, in this way we identify the VP inclination and we put the one identified mark. Then after, with the help of the scale, length of the line 90 mm, that's why 45 above the M and 45 below the M. Total length of the line is 90 mm. And we draw the here locus of, here also on a horizontal line, and same we extend the length 45 degrees here. In this way 45 45, this is the A1 dash and A2. Above reference line front view. Below reference line is the top view. A2, B2 is the top view, and A1 dash and B1 dash is the front view. These lines are called locus of lines. So this is the one reference line XY, and this starting point locus of line, M locus of the line, midpoint, that's why this locus of the lines are there. Okay, now this is the problem. Here now we extend this B1 dash to locus of line M with the help of the scale. B1 dash to we extend the B1 dash to we extend the locus of M, that is B1 here. Same here also, this line to front view to top view M locus of the line and top view to locus of M dash. Here also same, B2 locus of M, we extend the lines. We extend the lines up to locus of M here, B2 here. Then you take the compass, M dash is the center, M dash to B2 dash is the radius, you draw the one arc. And here also you extend the locus of the lines. In this way. And then after you draw, join the line here to here. Okay, join the line B dash to here. This is the A1 dash, this is A dash. This is A dash. Same here also, M dash is the center, M to B1 is the radius, you draw the arc, this locus of line here. Okay, in this way. M is the center, M to B1 is the radius, you draw the arc here B, and then after B2, midpoint to, you join this locus of line, it's right. Okay, this is the pink color lines. These are the projections of midpoint problem. Okay, thank you for listening. In this video, you learn how to draw the line is inclined to both planes HP and VP. In this situation, different cases are there. Midpoint problem and rotating line method and projected distance. These are the three methods. In these methods, we need to find out true inclinations, the true length of the line in different way. I think all are understand easily. Thank you for listening.